So today it's Saturday in the morning, 8:30, Saturday the 28th of March, and going out for some breakfast, the classic Malaysian breakfast called Roti Canai, which is actually very nice. So I'll see if I can get it from the shop just down the road. And I'll also stop by. There was a terrible fire yesterday, so I'll just stop by and see what happened. See shop fronts just now. Now we'll go through the back alley. Yes, this is the British urban planning system. This is very different. Someone peeing in the drain. That's where all the aircon units are, where all the rats run around. A real sort of beggar house scenario. Let's see. They normally have Roti Canai. Check it out. Morning. You have Roti Canai?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, good. Order from you or yeah. Yes, can I order Roti Canai?
Roti Canai?
Yeah. Can I order one plain and two cheese?
Okay, one plain, two cheese.
Yeah, okay. Roti Canai.
Cheese dua, cheese satu. Uh-huh. Plata satu, cheese dua.
Cheese dua.
Roti Canai. Roti plata satu.
Yeah. And yeah, you have fish sauce.
Yeah.
Take away. Yeah. More in view. is a food panda, one of the delivery. Wow. Food delivery companies. Actually, this weekend I tried to see if I could sign up as a food delivery in the weekends, since I like cycling and so on, but that was simply not possible. Because first you had to have a motorbike, the electric cargo bike didn't make the cut, and secondly you had to be a Malaysian citizen, which I'm not. Fish sauce? That's fine, yeah. Yeah, fine. Yeah, on each side. Yeah. Yes. Shop is actually right next to the place that had the fire yesterday, so I'll just go by real quick and look. I heard the fire yesterday when I was up early doing some work, and I heard people shouting. Morning. So it's basically here on the right where all the yellow tape Wow. It's really... used to be some kind of supermarket here. Oops. Some kind of supermarket. I think it was an electrical problem. See, here's coolant. Fridges with all the drinks still inside. And some shelves in the back. Wow. Really burned out. Do you know what happened?
Huh?
Do you know what happened?
No.
No, don't know. Yeah, I just saw the fire yesterday morning. But I don't know what caused it. Maybe electric problem or?
Yalah ni tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Bakar apa? Api. Malaysia, I speaking, don't want to speak English.
Okay, yeah. Second
to me. I don't speak English.
Yeah, okay. I don't know much Malay, yeah. Thank you. I saw it from my balcony. Most of the fire was visible from this alley. Basically, from here. Yeah. There are quite a few electric sparks in the salt. But, yeah, I really hope no one got hurt, but it looks like it was a shop that was probably closed. This was early in the morning, around 6 a.m. And this building is a house where people live, but that doesn't seem to be affected, so hopefully no one was hurt. Even these gas canisters here were charred. They could have exploded. But didn't, seems like it. So I was lucky, actually quite a few gas canisters inside there. Anyway. Terrible. So let me take the back lane way back. So many air cons. Wow, that security guard was also peeing in the rain. But I guess there's a lack of public toilets, so no surprise. In some parts of the city, you actually see the aircon units locked up with a grill so they don't get stolen. A bit like what they are doing here. So in some cities like Taipei, they have successfully made these back alleys into nice cafe spaces. Simply cleaned it up, gotten rid of all the ugly air cons, maybe moved them to the roof or something. And actually, those back alleys are in some cases preferred to the front of the shop. Because you're away from the busy street. And they've put in some trees. It's amazing what a bit of vegetation can do. Ah yeah, temperature. I've been cycling, so maybe I'm a bit hot.
No, it's okay.
It's okay? Alright, thank you. Alright. So, temperature check. Once that's one measure. Another measure is this door is now left open, so you don't have to touch that door handle with everyone else. So that's also good. And then the lifts have this piece of plastic, and it says it's being sanitized every hour. So yeah, but basically whenever you go home, whenever you reach home, just wash your hands immediately. All right, over and out.